अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह वहदा वस्सलातु वस्सलामु अला मल्ला नबी अबादा वला आलिहि वसहाबी अजमाइन। अऊज़ु बिल्लाहि मिनश्शैतानिर रजीम, बिस्मिल्लाहिर रहमानिर रहीम। रब्बी शराहली सदरी वयस्सिर ली अमरी वहलुल उक़दतम मिन लिसानी यफ़क़हु क़ौली। आई इनवाइट ऑल माय डियर ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स विद इस्लामिक ग्रीटिंग्स। एंड बिफोर कमेंसिंग माई टॉक आई वुड लाइक टू जस्ट गिव ए ब्रीफ यू नो डेफिनेशन ऑफ माई अरबिक रेसिटेशन एट द बिगनिंग ऑफ माई टॉक। Those are not any you know magical words to be pronounced before the non-Muslims. Those are just the praises to Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, extending salutations to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions Sahaba Ikram radhiyallahu taala anhum ajmain. As the time is very short, I'll be giving a brief talk on the topic of introduction to Islam. So the topic itself has got a huge you know matter and content to speak in front of the audience, but in a shortest span of time I'll be speaking on five terms which are commonly used whenever a non-Muslim or a Muslim hears the word a community by the name Muslim. So the first five common words are Muslims, Islam, Quran, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Allah. These are the five common terms which you hear about Muslims. Five common terms. Let me start with the term Muslim. Who is a Muslim? You know, we say as Muslim and non-Muslim. What is the definition of the term Muslim? Muslim, by definition, it means a person who submits his will and wish to the will and wish of God Almighty, Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. In this world, a Muslim cannot lead a life according to his will and wish. He should lead the life according to the will and wish given by God Almighty Allah Subhanahu wa Taala in the glorious Quran. And Allah Subhanahu wa Taala referred us as Muslims in the glorious Quran. If you read the Quran in Surah Fussilat, Surah number 41, Ayat number 33, Allah Subhanahu wa Taala in this ayat refers the believers of this Quran as Muslims, and he never used any other term except Muslims. The second term which we commonly hear about a community called as Muslims are the Quran. As soon as we you know hear about Muslims, we say that these Muslims, they believe in a book, they believe in a scripture called as Quran. What is Quran? Quran is actually the word, the book of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala given to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Given, what do you mean by given? Given means take it as a gift, take it as a parcel or something like that. No, it was revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the time span of 23 long years. In 23 long years, the whole Quran was revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam from Allah subhanahu wa taala. And this Quran does not contain the words of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. From cover to cover, from beginning till end, from cover to cover, everything in the Quran are the words spoken by Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. Not a single word in the Quran is of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Not even the name of the wife of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Not even the name of the friends of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. For example, if we write a book, if we pen down a book, what we do? First we write the biography, who is the writer, who is the speaker. There is nothing as the biography, there is nothing as the introduction of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Quran in the beginning. For every book we say, what we see in the beginning, we have about reader. There is nothing as such, because this is the word of Allah subhanahu wa taala revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the month of Ramadan. If you read the Quran in Surah Baqarah, Surah number 2, Ayat number 185, Allah says, "Shahru Ramadan allazi unzila fil Quran hudal lin nas wa bayyinati minal huda wal furqan." Meaning, this Quran was revealed in the month of Ramadan, and this Quran is the guidance for Muslims. No. Quran says it is the guidance for the whole of humanity. If you go onto the internet and search about the world population, the internet statistics, it says that there are about 7 billion people. How many? 7 billion people on the face of the earth. What does it mean? 700 crore people. Among them, 2 billion, 200 crore people are Muslims. And rest, how many are rest? 500 crore people are non-Muslims. So, Quran is basically the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not only for 200 crore people, it is for whole humanity till the day of judgment. The third common term we hear about the community of Muslim is Islam. What is Islam? What does Islam mean by term? Islam meaning submitting our will and wish to the will and wish of God Almighty, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Islam is not a religion. You should keep it this in mind. The key point of my lecture is that Islam is not a religion. It is a way of life. It is a system of life. Whatever you do in your life, from birth till death, whatever you do, it should be according to the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, given through Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the glorious Quran. So Islam is basically not the religion, it is the way of life for the whole of humanity. The fourth term is Muhammad. Who is he? We regularly hear this term, this name Muhammad, on TV channels, on debates, in newspapers, in every discussion of Muslim and non-Muslim, we hear this word Muhammad. Who is this man? Who is this man? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the glorious Quran, in Surah Anbiya, Surah number 21, ayat number 107, Allah says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ, meaning Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the mercy for whole of the humanity. For Muslims? What do you think? Is the mercy for Muslims? No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave a clear message. He says, he is the mercy for whole of the humanity. Many of the non-Muslims, not you, actually the people who are, you know, sitting in the West, they think that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam commanded Muslims to kill non-Muslims wherever you see the non-Muslims, just kill them. No. This is not the teachings of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Neither it is the teachings of the Quran, neither it is the teachings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through Islam. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us love and peace. The clear example you can see, the very example here, the example is, the Muslims and non-Muslims came together to arrange an iftar party, you know, iftar gathering. This is the example of universal brotherhood. But there are some people sitting in the West, so they want to malign the image of Islam. But there are also some people who know the truth about Islam. They know the true teachings of Islam. I would like to give you an example. Can you see this book? What's the topic? The 100, written by Michael H. Arndt. He's a Christian. What did he say? The topic of the book is The 100, a ranking of most influential persons in history. And being a Christian, the author of this book is a Christian. Being a Christian, he gave number one rank to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the most influential man in history, and he gives the reasons to it. In two lines, he gives the reason. The reason, look, the number one rank is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, being a Christian, and he gives third rank to Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, being a Christian. The reason he gives is, my choice of Muhammad to lead the list of world's most influential persons may surprise some readers and may be questioned by others. But he was the only man in history who was supremely successful on both the religious and secular level. What did he say? Religious and communal level. What did he say? Religious and secular level. These are the observations of non-Muslims, and these are of course intellectual people, and they do not want to create disrupt. between Muslims and non-Muslims. He is the trustworthy person. He is the person who has spoken the truth. He said he is the number one person. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not the you know the teacher of only Muslims. He is the teacher, the master, and the warner, and the prophet of the whole of humanity. The last term is, whenever you hear about Muslims, Islam, you say Allah. Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed the verses in the Quran, has revealed ayahs in the Quran to kill non-Muslims. To kill non-Muslims. And there is a ayah, there is a verse in the Quran. If you read Surah Tawbah, Surah number 9, ayat number 5, it says, kill non-Muslims wherever you find. There is a verse. But there is a context to the verse. What is the context? The context is, if you find non-Muslims at the battlefield at that time, that the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that command was given to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the believers for that time. It should not be generalized, and that command is not for till the Qiyamah. And in next ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if the non-Muslim wants to have peace, take him to the place of peace. This is the command of the glorious Quran, and this is the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As soon as you open the Quran, the very first verse, the very first ayah of the Quran gives the introduction to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who is Allah? The non-Muslims, they ask questions, who is Allah? Who is Allah? So the very first, as soon as you open the book gives the answer. It says, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Meaning, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All praises are for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the Lord, Cherisher and Sustainer of all the worlds, all the planets, and everything that exists in this universe. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Rabb. Allah says, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is God of the whole universe. And for Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. And for that universe, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the mercy. I am the Rabb for everything that exists, and my Prophet is the messenger, the warner, the guide for everything that exists in this universe. So these are the five common terms which are, you know, you hear it constantly from your Muslim brothers or non-Muslim brothers, or on the TV channels, or in the debates, or in the newspapers. So as a Muslim and a non-Muslim, we should have, you know, the basic information and the basic introduction to the terms of Islam. I just want to end my talk, because, you know, the time is going too far. So two verses of the Quran, two ayats of the Quran, where Allah says in Surah Al Imran, Surah number 3. Surah is chapter, and verse is ayat. Ayat translated into English as verse. Surah is translated into English as chapter. So Surah number 3, ayat number 19, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly mentions, gives the message to everybody. Allah says, Inna deena indallahi al-Islam. The only way of life is Islam. Inna deena indallahi al-Islam. The only deen acceptable in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Islam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the same Surah, Surah number 3, Al-Imran, Surah number 3, ayat number 85, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِ غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. That if anybody comes with any other way of life, comes where? On the day of judgment. If anybody comes with any other way of life on the day of judgment in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the only God, Allah says, that religion, that way of life will not be accepted. Other than Islam, nothing is accepted. Why? Because this is the truth and this is the haq that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed through the glorious Quran. And Allah says in the ayah that they will be among the losers. This is the clear message that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given in the glorious Quran. I request everybody present here, if you want to read the same verses, same ayahs from the glorious Quran, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has, you know, given to all human beings. We have the copy of Quran being distributed there, free of cost. You can collect it from our counter there. सूर्य आल इमरान सूर्य नंबर थी चैप्टर 3 वर्स नंबर 19 चैप्टर 3 वर्स नंबर 85 यू नो वेरी सिंपल रेफरेंसेस जस्ट गो एंड चेक एंड रीड द ग्लोरियस कुरान एंड यू नो फाइंड आउट व्हाट इज द ट्रूथ एंड व्हाट इज द बाय दिस आई वुड लाइक टू एंड माय टॉक वा आखिर दावाना अनिल हमदुलिल्लाह रब्बिल आलमीन
Beautiful, no mistakes, it won't let us down.